Bell's made a good start. The outside of the front row, you lead the field down the back for the first time. Down into the highway turn. Always been fast. Adam Burr is second. Beveridge is back in third. You've got Taylor Johnson. Dylan Rouse has gone back to fifth. Steve Wrigley having his first round car he purchased recently out of Queensland. So it's good to see Steve out of bitumen carts and now the 500s.
They're very good operator, there's no doubt about that. Once they get a handle on setting these cars up, this car, the certainly contender, Ricky Bobby. We go up to calling in the 82 machine. He is on it and on it well at the moment, powering away. We go back to the Adam Burr Motorsport machine. Back there, Dylan Beverly, Taylor Johnson, Dylan Rouse, and Steve Wrigley. Great stuff here from the little pocket rockets. Certainly had a red hot go.
Yeah, Rick Hall's managed to get himself a nice little gap there. It was 1.2 seconds last time by. It's still 1.2, but that's a sizable gap in the world of 500s. Yeah. Back to Adam Burr. And we saw this last season. Adam Burr really came of age in the world of 500s. Had a pretty good season. Dylan Beveridge had a better season. He won his first state title. Taylor Johnson sits in fourth, then Dylan Beveridge, Dylan Rouse, sorry, and Steve Wrigley, who's in danger of going down a lap here shortly. Three laps to go for Rick Hall. He now leads by almost 1.5 seconds, so he's managed to extend that. Looking really, really good. Out of turn number four, puts a lap on Wrigley. There is two to go for our race leader. He's extended it to 1.7. Beveridge starting to close in on the back of Adam Burr now, so he's doing a good job. That's the one chasing the 44 through the highway turn. White flag comes out. One to go for Rick Hall. Leads the way. Second is still Adam Burr. Dylan Rouse got caught up there behind Steve Wrigley, so it's ruined any chance of a challenge for second place. But the win will go to Rick Hall in the 82, second to Adam Burr in 44. Third will be Dylan Beveridge in number one. Taylor Johnson in 17. On the infield, that's not ideal. First night out for him. Car purchased out of Queensland. Just as COVID started.
Yeah.
Like all races, he started working on it on Wednesday.
Yeah, green flag at the ready. We are racing. Dylan Beveridge, Burr, Taylor Johnson, keeping on. Ricky Hall. Back there, keen to get amongst it. As our leader, Dylan Beveridge. I checked out his transporter earlier, built it 7 weeks in the off-season, and it is state-of-the-art. Some of the best joinery I have ever seen, like better than a lot of kitchens and other things. Really sensational stuff. Beveridge in command. He's well and truly stamping his authority on this one. Burr in second, Ricky Hall up to third. Go back to Ralph. Taylor Johnson, but our leader, Dylan Beveridge. Oh, just hooked the rut there a little bit. Didn't slow him down. Oh, that time though. Hooked another one coming out of turn two. Got it round. Got it going again. But he's lost a lot. Oh, and we've got Taylor Johnson almost over. She was up on the side.
A name that might not be familiar. No, it actually used to be creative.
Ah. So, yeah. An earthy name. We get set to get back into a Dylan Beveridge.
Yeah, Taz won Dylan Beveridge. He got that for a very good reason. He's been knocked on door for a long time. He's a good operator. And he leads the way out of turn number four. Their numbers will swell during the course of the season. Adam Burr sits in second. Then it's Ricky Hall, who had a good start to the night in 82. Oh, I put the commentator's curse on him. Wow, Taylor Johnson almost cleaned him up on the run through there. Got away with it. Hall's lost a few spots. Ben Harris goes by in 22. Well, Johnson in 17, but our leader putting a snap from a lap on Abby Smith. And it's costing a heap of ground. Adam Burr right with him now as they run up into turn number one. turn two. There are definitely some ruts in turn two that are all finding them.
Yeah. Well, it's causing Beveridge a few problems, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Burr, as you said, is right with him. And a couple of car lengths separating them. And it's interesting. Burr, a little bit faster out of turn two. Beveridge faster down at the other end of the track. Just the different setups. White flag being prepared, Friday. So Dylan Beveridge, well and truly in command now. Burr's struck problems.
Oh, yes,
and
it's
slow. Now he gets going again.
That's bizarre, isn't it? It's kind of strange.
Bit of a gear problem, I think.
What it's done, though, is it's made sure that Dylan Beveridge will get the wins. Check her out. Yes, it is. Dylan Beveridge takes the win in car number one. Second will go to Adam Burr in 44. He holds third.